Good morning. It's Wednesday, March 27th, 2013. My name's Stephen Whiteside, and I'm your host this morning for today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television. We're coming up to 7:30 a.m. on the East Coast, and stock index futures are sharply lower, so we are expecting to see some selling at the open on Wednesday morning. Well, the markets were actually up in Asia overnight. It's Europe that we're having a problem with this morning. It is a holiday shortened week, so the markets will be closed on Friday. I'm going to be off tomorrow, and so the next time you'll hear from me is next Tuesday. I'll be off tomorrow and Monday and back Tuesday morning. Now, it is a holiday shortened week. It is month end. It is quarter end, and all of those give the market a bullish bias. Now, if the market wants to go lower, of course, this bullish bias will help soften any downward pressure that we're going to see. Now, yesterday it was actually an inside day for the markets, even though the headlines are that the Dow made a higher high. That isn't that important. The S&P 500 came up. It actually closed above our mathematical resistance, but did not take out the previous high. If we were to break higher this morning, and that doesn't look like it's going to happen, certainly at the open, 1570.31 is our next target to the upside. Looking at the NASDAQ, a similar situation. It moved up yesterday, did not take out resistance or the recent high. If we do take out the recent high, then 2832.03 would be our next target to the upside. Looking at our pieces of the puzzle, bond market certainly is not supportive for higher stock prices here. Still trading in the channel, so rather neutral. So they're sitting on the sidelines waiting to see what happens next. Similar situation for the US dollar, still on a buy signal. Euro still on a sell signal, so no change there. The Canadian dollar moved higher yesterday, took out the recent high. Many people consider it to be a risk on trade, but this upward movement in the Canadian dollar might have more to do with the price of crude oil than anything else. Inside day for the VIX yesterday, so the VIX is not confirming what's going on in the stock market. The VIX is still on a buy signal right now, and we need to close below 1246 to change that. Now, yesterday I bought some call options. I bought the April 18th. They were down, closed down 15 cents on the day. I'm going to buy some more this morning, and of course that's in anticipation of the VIX rising and the stock market falling, and so those options are good to the third Friday in April. Looking at the VIX for the NASDAQ, again, this index is still on a buy signal. That would change with a daily close below 1155. So you can see that both bond traders and options traders are not supporting or anticipating higher stock prices right now. Take a look at the daily index charts. S&P 500 still on a buy signal here. It was an inside day yesterday. Inside day for the NASDAQ 100. The NASDAQ 100 cash index closed right above the upper channel line. If I was basing my decisions just on this chart, I certainly wouldn't take that buy signal. I certainly wouldn't take a buy signal for the Qs, which closed just half a penny above the upper channel line. And no need to worry about the E-mini. It closed just below the upper channel line, so no buy signal there. So any buy signals on index NASDAQ-related products, ETFs, futures contracts, I would ignore those on Wednesday morning. Russell 2000 inside day for the Zax Microcap, inside day for bank stocks, inside day for energy stocks, gold stocks for the XAU. We traded through the lower channel line on Tuesday but did not close there. A close below 133.98 would give us a sell signal on Wednesday, which would be rather unfortunate. The big number that you need to watch is the low from a couple of weeks ago. And so if you're a long-term investor and you've been sitting in gold stocks for quite a while, you really need to abandon any hope if we start breaking down below that recent low, because if that happens, we're probably going back to the highs from lows from several years ago. Similar situation for the Gold Bugs Index, closed below 351.79 on Wednesday would give us a new sell signal for that index. And of course, when you're following indexes, when an index generates a sell signal, you anticipate that most of the majority of stocks in that index will also be generating sell signals at that time. Looking at home construction stocks, so we're 50 cents away from generating a sell signal for this sector. I'll post a webpage about this sector later today. Beazer Homes, a second day of a sell signal. Hovnanian now on a sell signal as of Tuesday's close. Semiconductors moved up to the upper trend line once again, but did not close above it. We need to close above 433.89 on Wednesday to give us a new buy signal for semiconductors. Looking at transports, they also had an inside day. An inside day is a pause day. It's a day of indecision. It's a day in which neither the bulls or the bears can claim victory because we couldn't take out the previous day's high and we couldn't take out the previous day's low. So the market is still waiting for something to cause it to move above or below that previous day's high or low. And so it looks like what we're going to do at the open is probably reverse a lot of the gains we made yesterday. Again, that does not take us out below the previous day's low. We'll have to wait and see if that happens. And of course, if that happens, that would be a big tell for the markets. Looking at the commodity ETFs, starting with copper, traded into the channel yesterday, a close above 43.55 would give us a buy signal on Wednesday. For the GLD, traded down to the lower channel line once again on Tuesday, a close below 154.44 would give us a sell signal on Wednesday. For platinum, we're looking for a close above 155.94. For silver, we're looking for a close above 28.06. No chance of a sell signal for crude oil on Wednesday. Looking for a close above 61.69 for gasoline to give us a buy signal. And an inside day for natural gas, looking for a close below $20.94 to give us a sell signal on Wednesday. Looking at my five stocks, no changes in trend on Tuesday. We moved a little lower for Apple Computer, inside day for the CME Group, inside day for Google, inside day for Goldman Sachs, and we've got Visa breaking out after trading in a channel for the last couple of months. We've been able to break out over the last couple of days. Target on Wednesday is 168.75 for Visa. Last up this morning, let's take a look at some 60-minute charts, starting with the VIX. The VIX is still attached to the flypaper channel. With the markets trying to push to new highs, you'd think the VIX would be trying to push to new lows. And so that's a divergence telling us to expect lower prices here. Lower prices would mean for the markets would be higher prices for the VIX. So the VIX above 1334 would give us a buy signal. And we may see a movement up above that at the open. On the downside, an hourly close below 1555.64 would give us a new intraday sell signal for the S&P 500 cash index. For the NASDAQ 100, we're looking for an hourly close below 2795.42. And last up this morning, an hourly close above 134.84 would give us a new intraday buy signal for the XAU on Wednesday. Okay, folks, that's all for me for today. That's all for me for this week. Next time you'll hear from me is next Tuesday. Have a great day. Have a great long weekend, and we'll talk to you on Tuesday.